Hello, viewer. As most of you are aware, I have no car at the moment, so this is a film I took today, travelling from Nelson to Accrington by public transport. What you're watching now is entering Nelson railway station. Nelson is a small town in East Lancashire. It's around about 6 miles from a town called Burnley, where I previously lived. And I'm so glad you can't hear the sound on this bit, because I was totally out of breath by the time I'd got to this ramp. So there you go, typical East Lancashire rural railway station. There's no ticket office, nowhere to buy a drink. What you're looking at now is the actual road that I live on, and I live just at the top of that hill where that car's just come around the corner. It's called Railway Street. Appropriate. What you see now is just coming out of Burnley Central Station, and going over the bridge you get to see a good bird's eye view of Burnley. As you can see, it's also a typical Lancashire grey day, but it gives you some idea of how big the town is. And the bit you can see now is arriving in the town of Accrington. This is about 7 miles away from Burnley, but not too long on the train. As you can see, a very, very similar type of town. Thank you. looking at now is walking through Accrington town centre. I'm talking over the top of it because the sound from my voice is not particularly good. I think it makes it that bit more authentic when you can hear the cars and things going past. Accrington is the same as many towns in Lancashire. A market town. And you'll get to see me walking through the market in a couple of minutes. I'm actually on my way to a place called Maundy Grange, where I do my counselling practice, or therapy to those of you in America. For those of you watching in America, we are in fact driving on the right side of the road. That building there is the Market Town Hall. It says 4 to 3, and there's a bit of blue sky and the sun shining, which is very surprising, because usually in East Lancashire, if there's a Y in the day of the week, undoubtedly it rains. I'm just about to cross the road now without getting run over by a bus. And I'm just going to walk through the marketplace. But here you can barely hear me talking because I've got the camera at sort of shoulder height walking through us to not try and attract too much attention. You never know who might be selling something they shouldn't. And as I was saying, I'm on my way to a place called Maundy Grange, where I do my counselling therapy practice. And today I'm going because I'm actually on the receiving end of it. As part of my course, I have to have 12 hours or around 3 months therapy myself, so I can experience what it's like in order to be able to deliver it. Typical market stall. Coming up to a little shop where you can buy cigarettes. I'm not sure how this works on camera, really, you'll have to tell me, but this is a proper bird's eye view of walking through a town, so it'll be interesting to see what your reaction is to it. Those are obviously real people, not extras. This is what we call a zebra crossing, where it's allegedly safe to cross a road. And you can see in the reflection in the mirror in the shop there was a bus that wasn't waiting too long for me. And this street in Accrington is called Abbey Street. I have no idea why, but it's mainly just another shopping street. This is the post office coming up on the right hand side. And you can see the red boxes that we still use. trying to give you an idea of what's in the shops, but you can't see for the reflection. And we're just coming up now to the place where I do my work, Queen Street. Every street, no matter how small in these towns, has a name. And that's looking across. Maundy Grange. I hope you can read the writing when it comes in a little bit closer. Go on, here you go. Keep it still. Responding to local needs by providing time service. And I can't read the rest of it because I didn't keep it there long enough. But it's basically a place where anybody can go. With any kind of need, counselling is provided free, but people are expected to leave a donation depending on the income. Right, this is inside. The person that runs this place is a nun called Dorothy McGregor, and inside the building where I do my counselling is a little chapel, and this is the little chapel inside. It's really, really nice and sweet. I think Dorothy is a Benedictine nun. I don't know if that makes any difference to you. Maybe I can introduce you sometime. The light will change here now, yeah. So you can see the little statue there and the cross. And if we go across, there's a prayer book. And as in most churches, there's the organ. So that's it for this one. I hope you've enjoyed watching it. And tomorrow, if you're lucky, you'll get to see Nelson.